Maybe you know what standard deviation is, and maybe you don't, but chances are you've heard of it before. Do you know what it means? To help us understand this concept, let's take a look at these three data sets. They all average 10. But the values in data set 1 are uniform, they're all the same. Those in data set 2 are either 9, 10, or 11, and those in data set 3 range from 3 to 20. But the average or arithmetic mean of all three is still 10. Now, what if the makers of this product claim that their customers lost an average of 10 pounds? How would you know what data set they were using? Of course, you'd hope that it would be data set 1 or even 2, but it could just as easily be data set number 3. Standard deviation is that number that tells you how far numbers in the data set are from their mean. For this reason, statisticians often rely on standard deviation to get a truer picture of the uniformity or non-uniformity of points in a data set. It's related to variance, but the problem many people find with variance is that it's found from squared values, so it's difficult to compare it to the values in the data set. Standard deviation is the square root of variance, so it's in the same unit as the data set values. There are two types of standard deviation, population and sample. When data is available for all the members of a group and is shown in the dataset, we call that a population standard deviation. On the other hand, the term sample is used when data from some members of a population is used to make an inference about the larger population. The sample standard deviation figure will always be larger than the population standard deviation when they're calculated for the same data set. That's because the formula for the sample standard deviation takes into account the possibility that the true population may have more variation than the sample. Right now, we'll cut to the chase by saying that Excel has 6 functions to calculate standard deviation. The option you choose will be dependent on whether you want to calculate population or sample, how you want Excel to handle text and logical values, and the version of Excel you're using. There are 2 functions that are being retired by Excel, STDEV and STDEVP. So you should really only be using those if you don't have access to the newer functions. Let's break down the other 4 and when you should be using them. The STDEV.S is for sample data. It replaces the older STDEV as the sample standard deviation formula. Now let's take a look at this weight loss product and see how knowing the standard deviation gives us a better idea of how reliable that average of 10 is. We'll use it on all 3 data sets and compare them. As we can see for the first dataset, it says 0. There's no deviation because the values in the dataset are identical. In the second dataset, there's a slight deviation from the mean, but it's less than 1. This means that each value is quite close to the mean of the dataset. In dataset 3, this is a standard deviation of 6.9. So for dataset number 3, the average of 10 is a less reliable predictor of future values. What about population standard deviation? As mentioned before, we use this when all the information we'll be reporting on and interpreting is within our dataset. We usually use the STDEV.P function to measure population standard deviation. It replaces the older STDEVP. To demonstrate how it works, imagine that there are 11 boys in an English class, and their height in centimeters is shown here. In this case, since the population is only the boys in this class, and we have no intention of inferring anything about a larger population, we'll use the STDEV.P function to find out the standard deviation, and it's 3.3. On the other hand, if this were a random sampling of boys in a larger class, we would have used the STDEV.S formula instead. What if we added a text value to this population dataset? Well, both STDEV.P and .S ignore text values. If we do want text values to be considered when standard deviation is calculated, then we'd use the A versions of these functions, STDEVA for sample and STDEVPA for population. In each case, text is assigned a value of 0 and often results in a very different standard deviation figure. Whether this is new territory for you or you already understand statistical terms, Excel has an entire library of statistical formulas, and GoSkills is ready to break them down for you. Download the practice file and try out these examples yourself.
Ready to learn more about Microsoft Excel? Then check out the full course on GoSkills.com. Click the link in the description.